boys and girls and all children of God, child of God, Mrs. Toni here. I brought my Whirl Story Bible, and I thank you for turning this on and listening to the story with me and singing the song with me and praying to God with me today. Thank you for doing that. It makes me happy to picture you out there. Now I'm going to go way to page 438. Right away, you notice the yellow border is gone. Now it is Pentecost, the 50th day after Easter, where something very special happens. We see the little graphic in the circle of the flame with the dove flying down. That red makes us think of the fire, and the dove makes us think of the Holy Spirit. Let's hear about the Pentecost in a gust of wind. A gust of wind blasted through the house in Jerusalem. The disciples jumped up from the table. Andrew grabbed the bread. John and James grabbed the cups. The tablecloth flew into the air. Plates crashed to the floor. The disciples were celebrating the festival of Pentecost, but now their meal was a mess. Andrew dropped the bread in surprise. A flame of fire floated over each disciple's head. The flames were bright red, orange, and yellow, but they weren't hot. That sure would be fun to see, wouldn't it? Andrew pointed to the flames. Look! The disciples looked. John and James dropped the cups. Peter's and Simon's eyes grew wide. Bartholomew's and Philip's mouths dropped open. Matthew, Thomas, and Matthias gasped. Thaddeus and the other James pointed to Andrew's head. You have a flame too. Suddenly, the disciples began to speak in different languages. Latin, Greek, Arabic, all the languages of the whole world. They rushed outside. We are filled with God's Spirit, shouted Matthew. God is the ruler of all, Philip exclaimed. The street filled with Jewish people from many countries who were celebrating Pentecost in Jerusalem. Every person, no matter where they had come from, heard the disciples speaking about God's power in their own language. The people couldn't believe their ears. Some in the crowd sneered. They could not believe that the disciples could actually speak all the languages. But many other people were amazed. Peter yelled, "Each of you hears our words in your own language. God's Spirit made this possible." Whoa. Otto says, "So the disciples could suddenly speak all those different languages? I've never heard of that superpower before." Cool. And something tells us that Otto has heard of a lot of superpowers. Wow, there we are, Pentecost with the red. A lot of people wear red on Pentecost to remind them of the 50 days after Easter when God's Spirit came down into everyone and they could all understand. Now, I want to sing Father, I Adore You, which is a good song for thinking of God, his son Jesus, and the Holy Spirit, the three in one, the team all together for us. Here we go. Let's get centered in the Lord. Father, I adore you. Lay my life before you. How I love you, Jesus, I adore you. Lay my life before you. How I love you, Spirit, I adore you. Lay my life before you. How I love you. Now fold your hands and pray after me. Dear God, thank you for loving us so much. Thank you for giving us Jesus. Thank you for giving us the Holy Spirit. Help us to feel your great, great love and feel your great, great power every single day. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Hey, thanks for watching this video. Be sure to give us a like and even a comment. And please, please, please don't forget to subscribe to our channel.